look at this guy. This is a man who knows set design.
He was fixing
production
it.
Design.
He could tell.
Knows a little thing about offense as well. He's the quarterback of those West Texas A&M Buffaloes. It's Nick Gerber. I've been saying coach all day. Nick Gerber. Nick, it's good to see you, my man.
Yes, sir.
How
you
are
you? I'm good. Excited to be here. Meet all these coaches here and just get to learn new faces, new names, and look out for them this year on the field.
Because you're a bit of a newbie to the Lone Star Conference, a bit, you know. But let me ask you, we were wild about you at Leveland, wild about you. How do you think since then, since those days at Leveland, how do you think you've grown as a quarterback?
I think the biggest place that I've grown is off the field mentally. Mm-hmm. You know, just my mind's developed a whole lot. I'm in year five. That's crazy to think about because it felt like yesterday.
Dude, you're making me feel so old. Please don't say that.
So it's good. I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoy it more now than I did in year one. Mm-hmm. And Coach Hughes, he's awesome to play for. Our offensive coordinator, Coach Martin, he's awesome to play for too. And he's been good. This is my second year in the system with Coach Martin, and so I'm excited to see where this offense goes this year.
I'm looking this up. You are fourth all-time in Texas high school football career passing yards. But ahead of Graham Harrell. Do you know that? You have more passing yards than Graham Harrell. How about that?
That's wild.
Hunter Lyle, Travis Cantania, Andrew Boddy, and now Nick Gerber. Okay, so let's talk about, you know, transferring from Tech. You are a guy who had a great resume. You had your pick of the litter. You decide to go to West Texas. Why? I guess let me just leave it purposely vague. Why was West Texas the right move for you?
There was a few things. Number one, they were the first school that really reached out to me. Coach Hughes, he recruited me in high school before I went and signed with Tyler mm-hmm. out of high school. So I knew I had that relationship with him just because I've known him from my high school days. But then the stadium, if you've ever been to the stadium, it's mm-hmm. unbelievable. So the stadium, number two, it's close to home. I'm two hours away from home. West Texas traditionally in the past 2013, 2014, I mean, they were good football team. Mm-hmm. It's traditionally great football up there, and the Lone Star's awesome. And up in Canyon, they love their football. And mm-hmm. so people come out there and they support, and just the blueprint of everything that Hughes wanted to do, I think that it's finally coming into play, and a lot of things are finally starting to go our way. And I'm excited about this year because this is one of the years – a year like this is something that – it doesn't come along every year. So if we can stay healthy, I think this year will be a big year for us.
You guys went – you played – we were talking to Coach Hughes just recently. You played in the fall. You guys go 3-3. You know, I asked him why that was the right move for West Texas to play in the fall. You got a variety of different opportunities for – you know, some teams didn't play at all. Some teams played in the spring. What do you feel like you got out of playing in the fall? What was the advantage for you, maybe personally or for the team?
I think staying on a routine mm-hmm. is the biggest thing because, you know, you go and you get to keep your spring, your normal practices, your spring game. You get to play in the fall. You get to do your fall camp. So just the routine, and we're about to turn around and do it again. Like these teams that played in the spring, it's good for them. They deserve to play and everything, but now they're turning right around in mm-hmm. 2 months and they're playing again, and that mentally – I feel like that could really take a toll on some people because, you know, the season, it's a grind. It really is. You're going and you're always doing something every single day. So we got to keep our part. We got a little bit of a break in the spring, did our thing, and now we're going to go back and we're going to do it in the fall. And so I think just routine is the biggest thing. And I think that that's why we stayed on schedule. And another thing was injuries. Like if you got mm-hmm. hurt in the spring, it could affect you in the fall. Like it could transfer over into the fall if it's a longer injury, and so that way we're healthy as a team and we got everybody back, so I think it'll be really good for us.
Now everybody at home, watch this. This is a professional journalism move because I'm going to get him to be one of the most popular guys in his locker room. Nick, let me give you an opportunity to brag about your offensive line because it seems like you guys may have one of the best offensive lines in the Lone Star Conference coming into the fall. Is it safe to say you're excited to play behind those big boys up front?
Oh my gosh, there's no doubt about that. We got left tackle, this will be his fourth year starting. Mm-hmm. Center, this will be his third year starting. Right tackle, third year starting. Both guards, this will be their second year starting, but they also redshirted, so they've been in the program 3 years. So experience is there. There's nothing that's going to throw these guys off. And so that's something that I think I work really well with them, and they work really well with me. And then, of course, we use our tight end a lot. Mm-hmm. And you saw our big old tight end. He's
big boy.
6'5", 260 pounds. So that's another – he's pound for pound one of our best blockers. So – you know, that fires me up. And we got our running back. His name is Khalil Harris. He ran for, I think, 450 last year, but in six games. And some mm-hmm. of those games, we didn't play the second half because we were up on some of them. So he's unbelievable. And so just that in general, if you have a good run game, it translates to a good pass game, and the balance is going to be there. So I'm excited to play with these guys because they're experienced guys who know what they're doing and know how to get the job done.
All right, good. That's going to win you some friends in the locker room. There you go. And finally, your mom is in the Hall of Champions there at West Texas. Do you feel the pressure to live up to your mom's standard at West Texas? Is she holding this over you? She's like, yeah, you know, you can go out there and, you know, be a Harlan Hill finalist, but here I am in the Hall of Champions.
She doesn't bring it up just too much. One thing we do talk about is she won the conference. They went to the regional final her senior year, so that's something that she says that's unbelievable to experience. So that's something I want to experience mm-hmm. as well. And so just something that I want to add on because she has a ring, and yeah. so I want to be able to get a ring and bring it back to WT because it has been – last year they won their conference was in 13, so it's mm-hmm. been 8 years. So I think it's time to bring the Lone Star back to Canyon this year.
I think it's time. Nick Gerber, the quarterback of the West Texas A&M Buffaloes. Coach – or Nick.
Man, you got to get better at that.
I know. I'm sorry, I've been talking to you. Really good to see you, my man.
Yes,
best
sir,
of luck
too.
In the fall. Can't wait to see what you do.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Nick. There he goes, Nick Gerber, the starting quarterback for those West Texas A&M Buffaloes.
Thanks so much for watching that video. If you would like more and to be notified when they come out, go ahead and click that subscribe button right down there. You can also watch Texas Football Today every day live at noon on TexasFootball.com, Facebook, Twitch, and right here on YouTube. For more of the best coverage of Texas football in the Lone Star State, go to TexasFootball.com/subscribe.